Good morning and welcome to the Reagan Presidential Library. Everyone, please take your seats as our program is about to begin. Excuse me if I don't go through the process of recognizing our distinguished guests, because I think this is the first occasion in the Reagan Library where virtually everyone here is a distinguished guest.
What better way to kick off this forum? This library remembers a great Republican leader whose resolve ushered in the end of the Cold War. We could not find a better setting for a forum such as this. But Ronald Reagan did not do it alone. He worked with a Democratic Congress to put aside political differences and do what was strategically right and what was strategically smart.
We have this incredible need. We have 50,000 wounded warriors in the last decade of war. We have 1,800 amputees. We have an estimated 300,000 traumatic brain injuries, an estimated 500,000 post-traumatic stress, people dealing with post-traumatic stress. These numbers are overwhelming, and if we look out to 2025, where are we going to be in terms of how do we make sure and ensure that these wounded warriors don't fall through the cracks, that they get what they need, and that society is not overwhelmed with their issues?
In the discussion about war and its future, there are some words that are beginning to concern me a bit. Words like discretionary, words like limited, words like de-escalation, words like control.
Look, we 12 of our squadrons are down. Half of our Air Force planes are not ready to fly. We've got problems with deployment of our ships. We've had to delay deployments on our ships. We've delayed maintenance on our ships. Our rotational training has been canceled, so that we're not training in the mode we should be training. When you put all of that together, along with the furloughs of 800,000 of our civilians, which are a support system for our defense structure, all of that spells real trouble.
In quick summary, I mean, my concern in acquisition is we've just sort of drowned it in process and requirements, so that we're taking away power from individuals to make wise management decisions because they got seven layers above them. And if nobody, you know, if everybody's responsible, nobody's responsible. And we don't have the flexibility within the system.
The power of our military's global reach has been an indispensable contributor to peace and stability in many regions and must remain so. But not every outrage, every act of aggression, every oppression, every crisis should elicit an American military response.
We Democrats can steal Reagan's stories just as well as Republicans can steal Reagan's stories. President Reagan liked to tell of the time during World War II when Winston Churchill was visited by some ladies from the Temperance League. And one of them scolded Churchill, saying, "Mr. Prime Minister, it is said that if all the brandy that you have drunk since war began were poured into this room, it would come all the way up to your waist." Churchill looked at the floor, looked at his waist, looked at the ceiling, and then said, "Yes, madam, so much accomplished and so much more left to do."
We have got to deal with this. R&D is at the heart of our ability to be superior technologically. And of course, it's also at the heart of our ability to attract the best talent into our collective defense enterprise, so that we can actually get this done. So there are a lot of risk factors here that I think we have to be very overt about so that we can build a strategy, recognizing whatever constraints there are out there. We have to be strategic about this, and we have to ensure that the actions that we take support our strategy.
The truth of the matter is we need a balance, and we're working on that right now. I'm satisfied that we are doing the best we can with the budget that we have.
Our systems are tested frequently, and they meet all the specifications that we've established years and years and years ago.
Building on the legacy of President Reagan, then what has occurred here today in the confines of this building, bringing together some of the leading, most thoughtful individuals in our defense establishment, from Congress, from industry, from Department of Defense. So thank you all for what you continue to do, and those who, once again, who helped put this together. This is extraordinary effort.
better cut it.
All right.
That's it.
That's it.